Alan Pearce, perhaps Rory Turner could be brought into the picture for Waitakere. It's an interesting kickoff by Amicale, the ball all the way through to Danny Robinson. Waitakere nil, Amicale one, but Waitakere lead 2-1 on aggregate. Tim Myers. Here's Prattley. Waitakere looking to try and move the ball quickly in the opening exchanges of the second half. Kalaros. Saar. Saleh with a long ball forward, looking for Paul Nom. Matthews puts Prattley under pressure. He can't keep it in. Amicale have a throw-in. Well, there were many who thought that Amicale perhaps were in the weaker of the two groups, as we see Paul Nom's header go wide. Sorry, that's Jack Whitney. Yes, there were some that felt that the group containing Barr and Amicale was the weaker of the two, and given that Solomon Warriors and Hikari underperformed by their own standards, that somehow Amicale would be outsiders to progress to the final, regardless of qualifying for the semis. Well, they're certainly proving doubters wrong here today. Saar's long ball isn't going to do too much damage, if any at all, to Waitakere as they reset and go again. Shelley. That ball's hit Roy Krishna. Goes shoulder to shoulder, and it's a goal kick. Samuela Kautonga. Nelson Saleh Kalifi. Oh, and he's caught out there, just ponderous on the ball. The Amicale skipper, De Vries, might make him suffer for it. No, it's well picked up by Saleh. Masavakalo. Nom. Well, the touch was too soft. It was picked off by Sam Matthews. Now Waitakere have it. Chris Palmer. That's an interesting ball that's played away by the Amicale defence. Well, not entirely played away. They're still under pressure. Jake Butler loses out to Suleiman Saar. Joseph Nawe, the goal scorer. Tangis, easy one for Prattley to head back into midfield. Saar picks it up. Now Butler. It's a good first time ball by Tim Myers. Krishna, the danger man for Waitakere. Cross to the far post. Waitakere starting to ask questions. Offside. Amicale take the free kick quickly. Well, the flag did go up. I'm not entirely sure that was a free kick. It may well have been for a goal kick. It's a disappointing ball in by Kalaros. Coombs. Now, if Waitakere are going to get back into this game, they need Chad Coombs. He's been a consistent midfield performer. Advantage. Well, that's a nasty foul by Nelson Saleh, and it goes into the book. Very cynical challenge by the Amicale skipper, and unnecessary, because Chad Coombs was heading well away from goal. And Saleh just lashed out. Kater Zatuni has had a good game so far, the Tahitian referee. There's the first foul against Roy Krishna. Now look at this. Coombs heading away from goal and wallop. That's a silly foul. Coombs to the far post. Butler lurking. Chance for Waitakere. Over the crossbar from Krishna. Well, the question here will be, do Amicale have the know-how to grab a second goal? It's certainly one thing to say it, and you can certainly rally the troops and play with emotion and passion and desire, but unless you've got discipline and tactical application, it's not much use. Look at Paul Marshall. He knew it was an opportunity. An opportunity missed. Nawo. Well played by Nawo. Finds a fellow countryman Jack Whitney. Jean-Robert Yalou. Masavakalo's unmarked at the far post if Whitney can spot him. Cross goes to the near post. Paul Nom. Amicale. Shot was a soft one. Regulation stuff for Danny Robinson. Waitakere now. Palmer crosses to the far post. De Vries tries to cut back, goes with the right foot, and Mansale won't have an easier save to make. Gets the move going again. It's Masavakalo. Whitney. Nawo back to Whitney. Suleiman Saar. Saleh pushing forward. There's five Amicale players in advanced positions. Masavakalo. Brian Shelley copes with that moment of uncertainty. Kautonga. Amicale are really, really sitting deep here. That's allowing Waitakere players to filter in. There's gaps. Butler's unmarked on the edge of the Amicale penalty area. Plays in Krishna. First two touches not enough for Krishna to evade the defence. Yalou. Nawo's made a run forward. Good first touch from him. Still going, Nawo. He's got Nom and he's got Masavakalo in the penalty area. In comes the cross. It's hacked clear, but Waitakere still struggling with it. Here's Brian Shelley. Oh, problem for Waitakere. Good goalkeeping from Danny Robinson to the rescue for Waitakere again. Nerves jangling at Fred Taylor Park, and a handball spotted on Chad Coombs. Look at this, given straight to Finidi Masavakalo. Danny Robinson spotted the danger, was out there to throw his body at the ball and keep his team in the game. Well, that's a poor free kick from Saleh. Now Waitakere could possibly punish Saleh and Amicale. Well, De Vries has given it straight back to Saleh. Pressure off Amicale. That's a good ball forward by Saleh for Nawo with a long range shot. Oh! Not far away. Nawo with that right foot. It was a wonderful pass. The shot from Nawo, low, flat, fizzing. Just wide of the target. Good header by Coombs, Krishna. Alan Pearce is warming up just in front of us. Here's Krishna. De Vries. Oh, a chance. Good goalkeeping from Chika Mansale. Brave stuff from the Vanuatu and Amicale goalkeeper. Now Finity Masavakalo. This game is open right up. Paul Nom. Jack Whitney now. Can't link his pass through. Look at the gap in midfield. Chris Palmer's going to pick this up for Waitakere. De Vries has broken away to the far post. He's sort of back on the left, and that's allowed Coombs to run into space. He might fancy a long-range shot, Chad Coombs. That's an easy one for Chika Mansale. Masavakalo, long ball forward, away by Myers. Masavakalo. Nom. Masavakalo again. He's going to need options, or will he shoot? He's taken the latter option, and it was the poor choice of those available. It's a goal kick. This game on a knife edge at Fred Taylor Park. Spoke before the match about how important the first goal could be, and you can just see how the pressure has shifted from the visitors to the home side. You can never write Waitakere off. They've been in all sorts of situations, having to go up to Tahiti to beat Dragon after a 0-0 draw here. They achieved that. They lost to Auckland City at Fred Taylor Park. They went to Kiwatia Street having to win, and they did that as well. So don't write them off. Butler, measured ball in for De Vries. The cushioned header, the shot, just wide from Krishna. Hit sweetly, but not on target. Matthews with the header. Saar picks it up for Amicale. Kensi Tungis. Suleiman Saar. Nelson Saleh. Sam Kalaros. Finity Masavakalo muscled off the ball by Sam Matthews. Krishna gives it straight back to Sam Kalaros. Nom. Looking for a foul, he won't get that. He's played for it, clearly. De Vries, Krishna, Matthews, Palmer. Good first touch from Palmer. Krishna trying to wind his way into goal. Goal kick. Strong defending from Saleh. There were some hopeful looks from the Waitakere bench that perhaps that was a penalty. Shoulder to shoulder, well, you be the judge. You could cut the tension with a knife here in Funuapai. This game is wide open. The tie is wide open. A place in the OFC Champions League final beckoning for one of these two teams. Time is definitely on Amicale's side as it presently sits. They've got just under 32 minutes. They trail 2-1 on aggregate. If they were to pinch a second, well, Saleh. And it's out for a goal kick. Richard Ey looks on, the Amicale coach, a former Vanuatu international. Coombs. Kensi Tungis nibbling away at the ball. It's a Waitakere throw. Palmer. That attempted cross breaks nicely for Matthews. That's a good ball by Matthews. Nice touch from De Vries. Palmer is joining in, but De Vries can't unload the ball. Chance for Amicale to break. Whitney. Suleiman Saar loses out to a very good Sam Matthews tackle. Masavakalo has it. Jean-Robert Yalou turning into traffic. Well, players' touches on both teams starting to get a lot harder as the nerves ramp up. What the game needs, what one of these teams needs, is something of an X factor. Can Coombs provide it? Well, it hits Kautonga in the rib cage. It may have touched him on the upper arm. The referee spotted no infringement. Play continues. Sam Matthews. Krishna. Tried to blind pass just in behind for Aaron Scott. Coombs is unmarked at the edge of the area. Krishna can't cut the ball back. Nom draws Prattley in. Masavakalo. Wayward pass. Delicate touch from Myers. Now he stays forward. Picks Sam Matthews. Chris Palmer. Might look to play in Krishna. He loves those measured long passes, Chris Palmer. And when they come off, they look very impressive. Well, that's another impetuous and silly foul given away by Kensi Tungis. Paul Marshall, look at that. He's not a happy man at the moment. There's a substitution taking place. Jean-Robert Yalou has been taken off. Moffat Deramoa has been thrown into the game. So Waitakere have a free kick. This is in a good position. Clipped in to the far post. Well done by Samuel Kautonga. Very composed defending by the Amicale centre-half. Fenedi Masavakalo goes by Butler. Runs into traffic. It's played wide. Amicale. Jack Whitney's got targets in the middle of the penalty area. The cross was too close to the goalkeeper. Robinson goes long. Here's the ball in. It's too far away from anybody in a red shirt to do damage. De Vries. Suleiman Saar. Whitney. Masavakalo. Whitney loses a tackle to Prattley. It's going to be a Waitakere throw-in. No, it's going to be a Waitakere free kick, in fact. Daniel Nato is on, Jack Whitney is off, so two substitutions in rapid fire time for Amicale. Waitakere nil, Amicale 1. 2-1 to Waitakere on aggregate. And the double substitution signalling Amicale's intent. They've got to go for it. They need a second goal to take this match at least to extra time and not concede in the process. Roy Krishna. Still with Krishna. Now Palmer might wind this into the far post as we've seen him do so often. Nawo. Always asking too much of himself, Joe Znao, to get onto that clearance that he started. Tangis giving away another foul. This will suit Waitakere. It'll just break up this Amicale momentum. Tristan Prattley with a free kick. Fired into the near post. Oh, and it's a chance for Shelley. It's away by Samuel. Ball bobbling around in the penalty area. Samuel Kalaros was the defender who got his head on it. The crucial moment for Amicale. They can ill afford to concede. It would almost be game up, you would imagine, if the score were to be 1-1 here. Amicale would have to open up, and here's a chance for Coombs. Oh, wonderful goal by Chad Coombs. A wonder strike. Sheer delirium from the Waitakere players. It's exactly what they were looking for. You write them off at your own peril. Amicale distraught, but they fall into a goal of supreme quality. The first touch was great, the second was supreme, the third, unstoppable. Chad Coombs with a contender for OFC Champions League goal of the season. Look at that, the Chad Coombs smile. He falls to his knees, relief. The overwhelming emotion. That was some goal. You'll have to go a long way before you see a goal of that quality. World-class stuff. Masavakalo. Play continuing. Kalaros. Good win by the goal scorer, Chad Coombs. Still with Amicale. Nato winds the ball into the D. It's played away by Sam Matthews. Palmer. Kautonga plays that rather awkwardly. Effective enough. Tangis. Well, Amicale have got to come forward in numbers now. So the scenario is that for Waitakere to advance, they can secure a finals berth with this result. For Amicale to advance, they need two more goals. So if they win 3-1 here on the day, they'll advance to the final on the away goals rule. If they win this game 2-1, they'll be out 3-2 on aggregate.
Come on!
So still plenty of drama to come. There's 22 minutes remaining. If Amicale can score another one, what a semi-final second leg we're being treated to. Two fantastic goals. One to Joe Znao of Amicale, the other to Chad Coombs of Waitakere United. Nice touch for Masavakalo. Nawo can't get the ball in. It's going to be an Amicale throw-in. Ball fired in too far, too high, too wide. A real hint of desperation about that. Butler loses out to Nato, Matthews, Paul Nom. Scott, that's a very good ball by Aaron Scott for Roy Krishna. Palmer's there to Krishna's right. He keeps his run going. Chris Palmer can square for DeVries. Oh, he's missed it. That would have been the icing on the cake for Waitakere. Chris Palmer wriggled clear of Samuela Kautonga. DeVries was unmarked. You've got to test the goalkeeper from that sort of distance. Matthews. Myers. Still going, Tim Myers. Kalaros's throw was hooked clear by Tristan Prattley. Nelson Saleh Khalifa. Suleiman Saar. Waitakere 1, Amicale 1. 3-1 on aggregate to Waitakere. Amicale need two goals. And they would take the tie out on the away goals rule. Waitakere can progress if the score stays the same. That's a good ball in, Kalaros. Corner for Amicale. Well, dangerous moments for Amicale now because they've got to commit players forward, but do you leave one or two back to deal with Roy Krishna on the counter? Half a dozen Amicale players in the penalty area, headed clear by Butler as far as Nawo, this time on his left foot. Takes a deflection. Oh, it's hit the crossbar. Chance for Amicale. Handball. No, it's offside. Drama here at Fred Taylor Park. What a moment that was. The assistant referee, Terry Pitty, spotting an infringement. Look at this. This time it's the left foot of Joseph Nawa. It took a wicked deflection off Fenedi Masavakalo. Hit the crossbar. First touch from Samuela Kautonga, and then it struck the hand of a Waitakere player, but only moments before, assistant referee Terry Pitty had spotted an infringement. So close for Amicale, and a let-off for Waitakere. Good first touch from Khalifa. Paul Nom's got space. Amicale still battling away. Butler tidying up for Waitakere. There's the clearance from Prattley. Coombs. Now DeVries. The space opening up for Aaron Scott on the right-hand side if Palmer can spot him. He chooses to play in DeVries. Kautonga. Ambitious. And cut out by Krishna. That's an important interception. Oh, and the referee, not sure he got that one right, to be fair. Free kick taken quickly. Kalaros. Attempted cross hits Jake Butler. Throw and taken to Khalifa. Sends one into the far post. Headed away by Aaron Scott, only as far as Suleiman Saar. Prattley with the header away, and another offside. Well, a double change coming up for Waitakere. It looks as though Matt Kinnean and Alan Pearce are going to be introduced. Chad Coombs is one of those players being removed. Well, what an afternoon it's been for Chad Coombs. What a goal. What a strike. We know he can hit them, but it was the timing, and not the timing of the technique necessarily. It was just the tonic his teammates needed. Waitakere were flagging, and then a piece of sheer mastery with a long-range volley. Aaron Scott is off. Matt Kinnean is on. Yeah, clear offside from Amicale. A good piece of officiating. You must give credit to match officials in situations like that as De Vries gives it away to Kalaros. Deramoa. Nato fancies a shot straight into an opponent. It's out for a throw. Well, some coaches will tell you that in these two-legged knockout affairs that goals can come in quick succession. Amicale would need that to happen, you'd think, to keep Waitakere out, as Nato has a long-range shot. It's not on target. It's a party trick that Waitakere have pulled out in past ASB Premiership semi-finals. They're past masters at knockout football, particularly over two legs. So used to it in their own domestic competition, the ASB Premiership. They've got a bit to do here. Prattley. Ryan De Vries, nice ball. And the return pass is shanked out by Chris Palmer. Krishna does well to win a throw for his team. Palmer through the legs of Paul Nom. Prattley looks for Krishna. It's tidied up by Khalifa. Now Chikau Mansale. Strap yourselves in, folks. The next 13 minutes could be frenetic stuff as Amicale tried to haul back the deficit. They trail by two on aggregate. Alan Pierce, the substitute. Jake Butler, Roy Krishna. That's a good ball by Krishna for Pierce to cross. Good save by Mansale from De Vries. Chico Mansale's had a pretty good game for Amicale. Daniel Nato's ball for Joseph Nawo is a good one. Nawo can take on Brian Shelley. Kenzie Tungis for Daniel Nato. And the chip is harmlessly wide. Amicale needs something more than that. Difficult one for De Vries in truth. He was marked a lot more tightly than he was for his previous chance in a similar position. And perhaps even did well to get that on target at all. Nawo. Tungis. Suleiman Saar. Nice second touch by him. The third one was impressive as well. Nelson Saleh Khalifa. Suleiman Saar. There's a long ball trying to beat Matt Kinnean at right back. Sorry, Brian Shelley has slotted in at right back. Matt Kinnean has been shunted into centre half alongside Tim Myers. Kautonga. Kalaros. Nato, Masavakalo, inside for Deramoa. This tie still has plenty of legs left in it. Just over 10 minutes remain. Waitakere United 1, Amicale 1. Waitakere lead 3-1 on aggregate. Remember, they have two away goals as well, but if Amicale were to score twice to tie this up, they would advance. Now, a chance for Kalaros. Oh, and it's straight at the goalkeeper, a wasted opportunity. They can ill afford to make mistakes like that, Amicale. To get into a position like that, they have to start hitting red shirts, not playing it straight into the goalkeeper. Well played by Pierce. That's a great ball. A chance for De Vries perhaps to tie things up. Still going, De Vries. Oh, good save. The effort from Chris Palmer. Look at the frustration on Paul Marshall's face. The body language says it all. Mansale keeps Amicale clinging on. Look at this. De Vries lofting a little ball in. It looked like a combination of Mansale and Kautonga. The goalkeeper angry that Palmer even had the chance to shoot. Amicale's vital signs are slowly beginning to fade in this tie. Punch clear by Mansale. A counter-attack for Amicale. Moffat Diramoa. Picked off by Palmer. Clips one in for Pierce. The old master, Alan Pierce. Can he produce something special? He's trying to wriggle his way clear of Nelson Saleh Khalifa. Can't manage it. Now, Waitakere don't really need to come forward. Remember, they've got that two-goal cushion. Well read by Tim Myers. They don't need to break forward. In fact, given away, I just wonder if they might decide to try and sit in. That could be a mistake. Richard Ewai yelling at Samuel Kalaros to get the ball forward. They can't sit back now. They've got to go at Waitakere. Nelson Saleh Khalifa. Suleiman Saar. Daniel Nato. Saar switches play. Paul Nom has popped up on the left-hand side. He's got Masavakalo to his right. Alan Pierce trying to shuffle Paul Nom infield. Daniel Nato. Now Masavakalo. Well, there's players all over the place. It's broken for Masavakalo. Oh, and he's missed it. Danny Robinson to the rescue for Waitakere. Amicale coach Richard Ewai was off his chair. He thought there was a chance in the offering. It's back with Amicale. Long range shot. More in hope than expectation. Look at this. Finidi Masavakalo dancing through a sea of Waitakere players. He tried to pull the trigger at the crucial moment. The ball bobbled away and Joses Nawo was just sitting a yard or two off Danny Robinson, who gratefully clutched the ball to his chest. Nom, header inside, picked up by Butler, helped on by Palmer. Time the enemy for Amicale. For Waitakere, this clock can't go quickly enough. An absorbing tie, fascinating fixture on the day, plenty of excitement and two quality goals. Is there more to come? Sam Kalaros' first touch was not a good one. De Vries not doing his level best there either, as we see Nawo pump this ball into the penalty area. Can't find a red shirt. Khalifa beaten. De Vries now has got Pierce unmarked. He's got Krishna in the box. He lets it through for Krishna. Can he seal it? Good save by Mansale. The Amicale goalkeeper standing tall for club and country today. De Vries, good ball in. Intelligent piece of play from Alan Pearce to let it run through to Krishna. First touch, he was always stretching. The second, fired it straight at the goalkeeper, who still had to do plenty to keep the ball out. Prattley with the corner. Chance for Kinnean. Away by San Calaros. Daniel Nato. Infringement spotted. Free kick for Waitakere. We're inside the final 5 minutes. Amicale need 2 goals to advance. Waitakere just need to hang on and see this game out. It will be their first OFC Champions League final since 2010. And an opportunity to wipe away memories of that defeat to Hikari United. Prattley. Oh, good free kick. It was on target, had the power, and it forced Mansale into a save. Time the enemy for Amicale. Suleiman Sarr. Good ball for Nawo. Prattley had to do some defending. And Robinson backs him up with the catch. About a good 30, 35 metres. And it forced Mansale into a save. Calaros. Khalifa. Waitakere content to put all 11 players behind the ball. The onus is on Amicale to prize them open. They might be able to do it once. The question would be, can they do it twice? Because they're running out of time. Khalifa's ball into the penalty area. Away by Myers. That's intelligent defending from Brian Shelley. Cool, calm and collected. And still looking to get forward to the Irishman. Here he is again. Tried to stroke the ball beyond Samuela Kautonga, but couldn't manage it. And substitution for Waitakere, Ryan De Vries is coming off. Dan Morgan is being thrown into the fray. Waitakere must surely sense now that they're almost there. The pursuit of the quadruple is very much alive. Pearce. Away by Khalifa. A chance for Amicale to break. It's given away though, straight to Dan Morgan. Tristan Prattley. Palmer. Good run by Dan Morgan. Flag stays down. Krishna's unmarked. He can seal it here for Waitakere. Waitakere United 2-1 up, and on their way to the OFC Champions League final next week. And it's that man, Roy Krishna, puts the stamp of quality. On an entertaining afternoon at Fred Taylor Park, look at the ball in from Dan Morgan. Krishan takes a touch, draws Mansale, and then just calmly puts it in the back of the net. And Waitakere lead 4-1 on aggregate. And it looks as though it's game up for Amicale. Moffat Deramoa. Dan Morgan. Well, there are going to be scenes of celebration here very shortly in West Auckland. And I'm fairly certain that Paul Marshall will be leading the charge there. It's been a roller coaster of emotions for him this afternoon. You've probably been able to deduce from the coverage just how heavily invested he is in his project here at Waitakere United. He not only defended the ASB Premiership title, he added trophies to the hall. But this is the trophy that Waitakere want. This is the one that he wants. 3 minutes of time to be played, additional time to be played, minimum. That's a good ball from Nato. Oh, and a chance for Masabakalo. Takes a deflection and goes wide. Corner for Amicale. Joseph Nawo to take the corner for Amicale. Perhaps time for one last substitution for Amicale. Well, look, there's a protest from the Amicale bench. They felt that they might have had a penalty kick, perhaps. Amicale trying to get one last substitution processed. It's Channel Obed, who's stripping down for action. Waitakere have a chance maybe to add one more to the total. No, there's an offside infringement. Well, Deramoa, going to ground. Well, if the referee doesn't see it, he can't give it. And I wonder really if there was anything in that. It just seemed to be a tangle of legs, nothing cynical. Well, will we have time to see Channel Obed take the park? We might be running short on that. Morgan on the counter-attack for Waitakere. Alan Pearce starting to make a run in behind the centre-half, Nelson Saleh Khalifa. Joseph Nawo. Khalifa. It's a good attempted switch of play. Calm defending required, but not in evidence from Shelley. Waitakere 2, Amicale 1. Goals to Krishna and Coombs, cancelling out a Joseph Nawo goal. They lead 4-1 on aggregate. And it's Samuel Kalaros coming off. Channel Obed coming on. This is going to be no more than perfunctory. There can be little time for Channel Obed to make an impression here. Brave effort from Amicale. You have to give them compliments for the way they've gone about the task in front of them today. It can't be an easy one, trailing 2-0 from the home leg. But Waitakere have been too good, too experienced. And they had too much quality in the end. Oh, and maybe a chance for a goal. No. Ball pump clear to Krishna. Khalifa, well, he wants to watch himself there, Khalifa. He's already on a yellow card. Chika Mansale and Nelson Saleh Khalifa and Joseph Nawo all performed well for Amicale. As the final whistle blows at Fred Taylor Park, what a game to call for you. It was a drama from start to finish. No shortage of skill, technique, passion and drama. And Waitakere United have advanced to the OFC Champions League final for the first time since 2010. They will face Auckland City at Mount Smart Stadium next weekend, Saturday the 19th of May. And let's recap on the afternoon's action. Fifty-three minutes. Amicale almost punishing Waitakere for that wayward pass. Danny Robinson fast off his line to shut down Finidi Masavakalo. Real anxious moment for the home side. They were trailing 1-0. 2 minutes later, Amicale again trying to press their one goal advantage. A long range shot from Joses Nawo hit the side netting. Danny Robinson relieved to see that one fly past. And then one of the best opportunities for Waitakere. Krishna tried to work a ball into the pocket at the near post for De Vries. Chikau Mansale, brave goalkeeping. The offside flag did go up. It wouldn't have counted, but still, Mansale having a storming game for Amicale. There's very little he could do about this. This, for me, was close to a world-class finish. Look at that from Chad Coombs. Taken on the chest, pops it over the top of Nelson Saleh Khalifa in the right foot volley. If you're going to pick a player in Oceania who can hit long-range shots with technique, it's Chad Coombs, and he didn't disappoint. Fantastic goal, right at the time that Waitakere needed it. Pops it over Nelson Khalifa. Very reminiscent of a goal that Paul Gascoigne scored against Scotland at Euro 96. If you remember, he popped the ball over the top of Colin Hendry. The Oceania equivalent, perhaps. 69 minutes. Another opportunity for De Vries. Marking wasn't as tight as the previous effort that he had. And he had the beating of Mansale there, but he didn't get the ball on target. 10 minutes to go. Amicale chasing the game. Paul Nom played this ball in. Sam Kalaros, that's a poor ball in. And he had options at the far post. And look at the frustration from Moffat Deramoa, throwing his arms up. Nine minutes left. De Vries twisting and turning. Looked to set himself up. Played it into Chris Palmer. Palmer's shot had plenty of power on it, but it was straight at the goalkeeper. And Sammy Kautonga both combining to get the ball over. Mansale angry with his teammates for allowing Palmer to have the shot. Just 60 seconds later, Finidi Masavakalo trying to trip his way through six players. The ball broke for Joses Nawo, but Danny Robinson read it like a book. And he was out to cover the danger very bravely indeed, the goalkeeper. Six minutes left on the clock. De Vries plays the ball through. Intelligent dummy from Alan Pearce. Chika Mansale forced into a save from Roy Krishna. Wonderful stuff from Pearce. And Krishna's shot straight into Chikau Mansale. Two minutes to go. Dan Morgan set Krishna up. He put the icing on the cake for Waitakere. Lovely finish. And Krishna's sixth goal of the campaign. And Waitakere 2-1 up on the day and 4-1 up on aggregate and through to the OFC Champions League final. Takes the applause of his coach, Paul Marshall, in the foreground. And it's thumbs up from Dan Morgan. So we can join Amicale coach Richard Ewai, who was sidelined, with Olivia Hook.
Thank you, yeah. Well, I'm very happy with the boys in the first half. I think we lost concentration in the second half, but one thing is I'm not happy about it, it's the ref. Some of our mistakes today with the ref, and but like I said, this is the game. So, but I'm really happy with the boys in the first half and the second half. Like, we dominate the game, but only to put the ball in the net. That's the same mistake we done in Vanuatu, the same mistake we done here. The only chance we don't put the ball in the net.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
happy with his team's attitude and display, perhaps has a grievance with other elements of how this game unfolded, and certainly highlighted several missed chances in the first leg in Port Vila. They missed some opportunities here. I don't know that there were too many clear-cut chances that were squandered. They did get into good positions and perhaps didn't take advantage of those. But it's academic. It will be a Super City Derby final for the OFC Champions League as we join Paul Marshall, coach of Waitakere, who's with Olivier Hook.
I guess you're really happy you qualified for the final.
Yeah, I mean, we're really happy to qualify for the final. I mean, that's the most important thing, is getting through. Not as impressed with our performance, particularly in the first half. But you know,
you're scared a little bit at the first half.
No, not scared's the wrong word, you know. But I mean, we were just disappointed that I was disappointed. The staff were disappointed that we didn't get up for the game as well as what we should have done in the first half. And so we didn't play our best, but we did a lot better in the second half. Created a lot more opportunities, and you know, we were comfortable in the second half. But first half, you know, and then we had the goal, which was a bit unlucky, really, off the back of the goalkeeper. But that's what happens in these games, particularly against the Ireland teams. The unexpected happens, you know, and you got to be ready for it.
Now the final against a team you know pretty well.
Yeah, Auckland City. You know, it's the seventh time I think we've played them this year, and it will be the seventh time, so you know, we both know each other pretty well, and at the end of the day, I think it's going to come down to you know, the odd little bit of detail, but we'll see how the week goes, and we're looking forward to it. You know, it's it'll be a great opportunity for us in many respects. We'll be able to, hopefully, if we do well, we'll convert a quadruple, which I don't think's been done before. So we've got a lot to play for. Yeah.
Thank you, Paul. Congratulations. Thanks.
So a very happy Paul Marshall. Not entirely happy with the first half, but he's got the result that he's been after. And as he says, the Waitakere United quadruple dream remains very much alive. They'll take on Auckland City in the OFC Champions League final on May 19th. And the winner will advance to the FIFA Club World Cup in Morocco in December and snare with it a $500,000 US prize purse. I'm Gordon Glenn Watson, and it's been an honour and privilege to describe the action for you today at Fred Taylor Park. We look forward to seeing you next week for the OFC Champions League final, Waitakere United versus Auckland City. Wherever you are across the Pacific and around the world, take care, and we'll see you next time.